Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. I'm with Casey Armitage here. She's a crossing guard who very responsibly carried a firearm, but the local city government had some problems with that, ruled that she should no longer carry a firearm, and it's getting some attention lately. So here we are. I want to thank you for taking the time to talk to me. Why don't you tell everybody what happened?
Well, I had some concerns over if it could be construed that I was concealing a firearm on school property, given the fact that my vest says school and my stop sign says school. And I went to my police chief and voiced those concerns to make sure that my lawfulness was still covered. And he let me know that there was an employee handbook policy stating that there was no conceal carry. He did mention, though, that it didn't talk about open carry, and then he said he would go to city council with that.
Right, and something that people need to know about Michigan, that open carry is the law of the land, and if you have a CCW, okay, you can open carry in gun-free zones. People don't understand that even in this state. Now, you have the CPL is what we call it in Michigan.
Yes.
You have the CPL, which does require a background check, range testing, range shooting, and a written exam. You passed all that, and yet they are not affording you the right to carry on your job, right?
No, they are not allowing me any right to carry at all. When the city council found out there was a loophole in their policy stating, you know, not mentioning open carry, they quickly had meetings so that they could vote to also prohibit open carry as well. I had urged them to please table the issue. At the time they were making the decision, it was very feelings based. Everybody had a lot of feelings of why they didn't think a crossing guard should carry. I let them know that we can't govern on our feelings. We can't govern on what ifs, and that I lost
and
my
that, and that, well, that's okay, because a lot of times the feeling based decision making is not necessarily what's best. You know, how you feel, or what if. If we play the what if game, we're gonna win that argument.
Oh, absolutely. I quickly let my city council know that we could have what if'd all night long.
Well, and my question is, have they increased their security? If they're not gonna allow you to protect the children that you cross, have they done anything to increase security?
No, nothing would change at all. Just I would be disarmed, and the rest of the city employees would be disarmed as well. Nobody would have any options to carry at all.
Well, and the funny thing also is that they said they are basing this decision on being conservative.
Yes, they did. They did. They cited that this was a conservative decision to go ahead with the vote at the time. It's definitely not a conservative.
Well, no, it's actually very liberal, because it's the liberals who base on feelings and what if, you know, it's not a conservative standpoint. So are you getting support from your fellow community members?
Absolutely. I have had an overwhelming amount of support from my community members. I've had several mothers come to me and let me know that they feel safer with me carrying, watching over their children as they go to and from school. I've had support far beyond our community, and I'm not giving up.
Well, I appreciate you taking this on. I appreciate your protection mindset that we need so much in our communities, and especially around our children. And we know that the world's not the same, and we need people right there on the lines, because you know what? The police, they're not gonna be there on time. And I know that you've stated that within one of the articles that.
Absolutely. When seconds count, police officers take minutes to get there. And I'm sorry, but when something is happening, my first reaction is not to pick up my cell phone. I'm not thinking about making a call. I'm thinking about taking action. And I just wanna be able to go about my business prepared and able to take action should something arise.
Well done. Keep it going. And I'm glad that so many people are showing support. And what we need to do is continue to get that word out there, change that mindset, and really change into some true conservative viewpoints. And that is protection of our children and our communities.
Absolutely. I'm very much hoping to set a precedence. There's no reason to disarm the city employees. The only factual argument they have is that their insurance rates could change. They could be dropped, or, you know, the rates could skyrocket. But we can't continue to govern over insurance and corporate greed and all of these things.
Especially if they're not willing to increase security.
No,
if they're not going to increase security, then we have to take it upon ourselves. So I appreciate this fight.
Absolutely.
All right,
absolutely.
Keep it going. Thanks
Thank
again.
You. Thank
all
you.
Right, I appreciate you watching, and you guys be safe.